Hello everyone, I am CA Vibhuti Naran. Welcome to our channel VN Practical Destination. In today's video, I'll be discussing about the GST Input Tax Credit Adjustments, also known as the ITC set of rules. That is how the input tax credit avail is to be adjusted under the respective heads. Now, for the convenience, or you can say for understanding purpose, I have divided this video or this whole topic into four basic adjustments. So in the whole video, I'll be discussing these adjustments in four types. Means adjustment number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So moving on to the very first adjustment, which is adjustment number 1. And this is a case where CGST, SGST, IGST, that is all the three heads are payable. It means it is a case of no adjustment. When you have all the amounts payable, that is your sales are more than your purchases, so there is case of no adjustment. That means we need not adjust anything under any head. For example, let us understand, we have CGST, SGST and IGST. So under all the three heads we have our output, then we have input, and then after that we have payable. So in all the three heads, that is CGST, SGST and IGST, all the three heads, your local sales are more than your local purchase, as well as in the case of IGST, your central sales is also more than your central purchase. So whenever your sales is more than purchase, that is your output is more than input, we have a case of payable. And under all the three heads, if it is a case of payable, so there is a case of no adjustment. It means we do not have to adjust anything under any head. For example, we have the output of 1000 rupees respectively in CGST and SGST and 1500 output in IGST. Input we have 600 in CGST and SGST, and IGST input is 700. So we have payable of 400 in CGST, 400 in SGST and 800 in IGST. So if all are payable, we do not have to adjust anything. The next adjustment, which is adjustment number 2, which says that CGST and SGST cannot be adjusted among each other. That is, I'll divide this adjustment into two cases. The first case will be you have CGST payable and SGST credit, and the second case is you will have SGST payable and CGST as credit. So let's move on to the first case, which is CGST payable and SGST credit. In this case, we have CGST and SGST, and we have output under the both as well as input. But CGST is coming out to be payable and SGST answer is coming out to be credit. So in this case, these both, means CGST and SGST, cannot be adjusted among each other. You will think out ki how it's possible, because we have the same rate, means output and input, we have the rates as same in CGST and SGST, then how come there can be a difference among the two? The first very possible reason is that at the time of introduction of GST, when VAT and CST were applicable, the opening balances of VAT and CST at that time, they were not equal. So it is a case that when we added VAT balance to SGST and CST balance to CGST, they were not equal, so there is a difference in the amount. The second possible reason is the adjustment number 3 and 4, which is related to the IGST adjustment, the balances are forward, there can be a difference due to the adjustments in adjustment number 3 and adjustment number 4, which we will be learning further in the video. For example, for this illustration, we have an output under CGST of 1500 and SGST 1500, which is same. Input is coming out to be 1200 under both the heads, but we have the difference in the opening balances. We have opening of 40 under CGST and 500 under SGST. So making up a total input of 1240, that is 1200 plus 40 under CGST head, and total input of 1700, that is 1200 plus 500 under the SGST head. So we'll find out that the payable under your CGST comes out to be 260. Now how this figure of 260 came, which was output 1500 minus 1240 total input, the answer came out to be 260, and your output was more than your input, so we have CGST as payable. Under the case of SGST, we have 1700 as credit and 1500 as output. So the 1700 input is more than output, so we have a credit balance of 200. So we'll be preparing a challan for the payment of CGST, means in this case we'll be preparing a challan for the payment, and this credit can be carried forward in your next tax period. So this was case number 1 of adjustment number 2. We'll move on to the next case under the same adjustment, which is case number 2, which is CGST credit and SGST payable. So we'll be having credit balance under the CGST head and payable balance under the SGST head. So in this case also, we cannot adjust both the credits and payable among each other. For example, here we have 1500 output under both the heads, 1200 input under both the heads. The opening credit of CGST is 350 and the opening credit of SGST is 500. So we have total input of 1550 under CGST and 1250 under SGST. If we consider CGST, your input is 1550 minus the output, which is 1500. So we have a credit which will be carried forward in the next tax period. And in SGST, we have 1500 as output and 1250 as input. So we have 250 as payable, which we have to pay through a challan. So we'll revise it once again. We have adjustment number 1, in which all the three heads are payable, and it's a case of no adjustment. We have adjustment number 2, in which we have CGST and SGST, either credit or payable, and they cannot be set off or adjusted among each other. We'll move on to adjustment number 3 now, which says the adjustment of IGST payable. Now all the first two adjustments did not deal with particularly IGST head. Third and fourth are particularly for the IGST head. So under the IGST, if the IGST turns out to be payable, which is covered under adjustment number 3, this adjustment is also known as central sale and local purchase adjustment. Means we have more of central sale and then we have local purchase. Let's understand this first of all. What does this mean to say? We have CGST, SGST and IGST, output, input, and we have payable only under the IGST and credit under the head CGST and SGST. So we can adjust the credit of and SGST with IGST, but there is a twist in it. You have to first of all adjust the CGST credit, and after that, if any balance after the payment adjustment of CGST credit is left out, then you can utilize the SGST credit. Means the order of utilization is fixed. First you have to utilize your CGST credit, and even after utilization of CGST credit, any balance of IGST payable is left out, then you can utilize your SGST credit. So first we will adjust CGST credit, and then we will be adjusting your SGST credit. For example, we have a credit of 1500 under CGST and 1500 under SGST. Under the IGST tab, we have a payable of 2500. So what we have done in this case is, first we'll be adjusting your 1500 of your CGST credit. This is the first thing which we'll be adjusting. Once you have adjusted this with your CGST credit, you have a balance left out of 2500 minus 1500, which is 1000 rupees of IGST payable. Now this IGST payable, if left out, then you have the second preference to the SGST credit. We have adjusted only 1000 rupees with the SGST credit because this was only the balance payable under your IGST head. Here we have 500 as credit, which will be carried forward in the next tax period, and we have no balance payable under the IGST head. So this was your adjustment number. Now we'll be learning about a very important adjustment. This is also the last adjustment, but I'll say the very important adjustment because there has been a drastic changes in this rule from the introduction till date. This is adjustment of your IGST credit with CGST and SGST output. Now this is also known as central purchase and local sales adjustment. This adjustment I have divided into three phases, means from the introduction of the GST, that was 1st July 2017 till date, there have been two times the changes or notifications came due to which there was changes in how to adjust the IGST credit. So the first two phases, you can say they are no more relevant or not much of importance for you, but for a comparison purpose I have covered those phases. The last third phase will be applicable for today's scenario. So the first phase, which I'll cover quickly, which is from 1st of July 2017 to 31st of Jan 2019. We had CGST, SGST and IGST. We had output of both three things. Then we had input. Table is coming only under CGST and SGST, and we have a credit balance of IGST. Now, as the adjustment number 3 was there, you can first adjust the IGST credit with CGST payable. That is the first priority. And the second priority, if any IGST credit is left out after CGST payable adjustment, then you can adjust that credit with your SGST payable. So first we will adjust IGST credit with CGST payable, and then if any left out, then with SGST payable. So the illustration also says the same thing. We have 2500 as credit under your IGST head and 1500 payable under both CGST and SGST head. So first priority, that is 1500 credit fully to be utilized with your IGST credit, and the balance 1000 can be adjusted with your SGST payable. So we have a balance payable of SGST of ₹500. So this was earlier the first phase which was there, which is not applicable as on today. The second phase was for a very limited time, you can say from 1st of February 2019 to 31st of March 2020. On portal that was not much relevant, that simply said that if you had an IGST, you have to first utilize it with the CGST output. So the twist or turn comes here. It is not CGST payable, it is CGST and SGST output. And the priority was also set that you have to first adjust it with the CGST output. And if any balance is left out, then you will be adjusting it with your SGST output. So this phase was not for a very longer time, so I will not discuss it in detail also. The illustration said that if you had an IGST credit of 2500, so you have to only adjust it first with CGST output, and then if any input of CGST is there, that has to be carried forward. If the whole amount was 2500 was adjusted with your CGST output, we didn't have anything to adjust with SGST, and that SGST after the adjustment with the input was to be paid. So this was only for 2 months, because from 1st of April 2019 and on 23rd of April 2019, the government came up with a new notification, and that process is still followed till date. Means as on today, this is what the portal is accepting. And this adjustment says that you have to be very careful for understanding this. If you have any credit under your IGST, that is to be utilized with CGST and SGST output. That is clear that from phase 2 it was said that it will be adjusted with output. The important thing to understand is that it can be utilized in any order. In any order means the sequence is not defined, that first you have to utilize with CGST and then with SGST, that is not applicable. So as per your convenience or as per your input, because what used to happen was CGST used to get credit of CGST used to get compiled up. So that's the reason why they have came up with the notification that you can utilize it any manner you. So IGST input tax credit is first to be utilized for payment of IGST liability. That is definitely you will be adjusting with your current input of IGST. And if any remaining balance of ITC IGST is left out, that can be used towards payment of CGST and SGST liability in any. For example, let's understand this example in a detailed manner. What we had was, we had a credit of IGST of 2500 rupees and we had to adjust with the output. What I did was, I knew that I had an input of CGST of 1000 rupees. So what I did to get a balance output of 1000, I adjusted 1500 rupees to make the credit as 0. And the balance 1000 rupees I adjusted with the SGST output. So we had a 1500 output under the head SGST, and I adjusted this 1000 rupees input and 500 became payable and the challan was to be prepared. The second option could be, see, in this case there can be various permutations and combinations. In any manner you can utilize. You can also do 1250 under CGST and 1250 under SGST. You can also make 1000 under CGST and 1500 under SGST. So there is no fixed manner of utilization, due to which in any manner you want, you can adjust your IGST credit between the two. So I'll make you quickly revise the four adjustments. The first adjustment, all the three heads are payable, you need not adjust anything. The second adjustment said you had CGST and SGST, both the balances, credits or payables cannot be adjusted among each other. The third adjustment said that if you have IGST payable, you will be first utilizing with CGST credit, and after it, if any payable is left out, after CGST credit utilization, you can adjust the IGST balance with your SGST credit. The last adjustment, which is applicable as of now also, if you have IGST credit, you can utilize the credit with the CGST and SGST output in any manner you want to. Now, whatever I have covered in today's video, that is also available on my website, which is vnpracticaldestination.com, under the head course outline, GST part 1 and GST adjustment. So if you want, you can go for the detailed conceptual part. For the whole concept, you can refer the concepts in the website also. Besides these, I also teach online as well as offline for the practical training of these subjects. So if you want, you can go for the registration as per your convenience for the class, online classes. That's all for today's video. If you like my video, then please press the black thumb blue and subscribe to my channel for latest updates. Thank you very much.